So today we are going to learn about how to design a tension member. There is a question where a tension member which is 3 meters long and carries a factor load of 200 kilonewtons. We have to design a suitable single unequal section when the connection is made up of bolt and fillet. So to design a tension member, we need to identify what are the different types of failures in tension members. When we study different types of failures in tension members, there exist 3 cases. The first case is with respect to yielding. Second case is with respect to rupture. And the third case is with respect to block shear. What happens when the section started to yield? So when the section started to yield, it causes excessive deformations, which will be highly unsuitable when we talk about limit state of serviceability. So that is why we have to check this section for excessive deformations. For that purpose, the tensile strength is checked in the case of yielding. So this is a criteria for which we have to follow. This is the formula for which we have to check it for yielding. When we talk about rupture, rupture causes because of tension. Because of tension, the failure, the plate will break into 2 parts, which is because of which we call it as rupture. And the criteria for this is given in clause 6.3. And this is the formula. And this formula is only for single angle. There is a reason why we use the formula. This is the formula for single riser. There is a reason why we use this formula for single angle. We'll discuss that when we go to the problem. And the third case of failure is block shear. It is a combination of both shear as well as tension failure. Shear and tension failure. So these are the 3 different forms of failures which occurs in tension member. Block shear generally fail by a section of a block which will fail because of a combination of shear as well as tension force. So a tension member will possibly fail in these 3 criteria: yielding, rupture and block shear. To design a tension member, the 3 following criteria should be checked. Our tension member should be safe in yielding, should be safe in rupture, and should be safe in block shear. To initiate my design, I need some base points. For example, the load is given over here. My tension member, it is clear that my tension member should resist a load of 200 kilonewtons. What type of section I have to select? It is also given in the question that I have to select Indian standard unequal angle. If I am going to select Indian standard unequal angle, what should be the dimensions of angle? So first thing, we need to have some basic step to calculate the dimension of angle. For that purpose, we know that the 3 formulas, the design should be such a way that in yielding, the strength should be greater than 200 kilonewtons. In rupture, the strength should be greater than 200 kilonewtons. Even in the block shear, the strength should be greater than 200 kilonewtons. For that purpose, any one of the 3 cases will be selected for basic preliminary design. So let us start with our yielding, as the formula is a lot simpler and we will get the direct gross area in this case. Remaining 2 cases, we can obtain only the net area. And here the area is with respect to shear zone and tension zone. So let us start with yielding. Before that, let us write all the given data. Given length of member, which is 3 meters, factor load, which is 200 kilonewtons, factor tensile load. Now first we will design our criteria with. So first we will start by finding the dimensions of angle. To calculate the dimensions of angle, we will check it with the formula of yielding. For that purpose, we know that the load P must be greater than AG Fy by gamma M0. So from this, we know that the load should be resisted, should be greater than 200 kilonewtons, then only our angle will be safe. For that purpose, substitute here the load as 200 kilonewtons, AG, the area, gross area, which we are going to find, yield strength of member, which is 250 megapascals, by partial safety factor, which is 1.1, and this value can be selected from table number 5. Depending upon the condition, either we are going for a collapse or either we are going for serviceability, table number 5 in IS 800 2007. So when I calculate the gross area from this formula, we will get this value as 880 mm square. So my angle section for my design, the gross area should be greater than 880 mm square. So increase this area either from 10 to 20%, because this is just for primary consideration, and all the cases we should satisfy. Should satisfy in yielding, rupture, as well as block shear. For that purpose, increase this value by 10 to 15%. After increasing this value by 10 to 15%, from SP6x1, which is your steel tables, select ISA 75 by 50 by 10, which is having a gross area of 1152 mm square. And centroid in x direction will be around 26 mm square. So if I calculate the value of TDG with this one, if I calculate the value of TDG with the given area, which will be about 261.8 kilonewtons, greater than 200 kilonewtons. So the section is safe in yielding. The design is not yet finished for tension member, just it is safe in yielding, so we can directly proceed to check for rupture and block shear. Before that, we need to design the bolt connection. We know that our angle section, which is 10 mm thick, and one leg of length of one leg is 75 mm, and length of other leg is 50 mm. This is our angle section, and having a gross area which is about 1152 mm square. The centroid of this angle is about 26 mm. Now let us design bolt. First case, we are going to solve this for case 1, bolt connection. To solve bolt connection, we have to know what are the different types of failure we can come across bolt. So these bolts are generally 4.6 grade black bolts, generally used for the design of bearing type of bolts. So when we see the design with respect to bearing type of bolts, our bolt connection will fail in shear as well as it will fail in bearing. So we need to calculate the bolt value, and our bolt connection should resist a factor load of 200 kilonewtons. So our aim should be such a way that whatever the bolt I am designing here, it should resist a load of 200 kilonewtons. For this purpose, first we'll calculate the strength of bolt in shear. Then we will calculate the strength of bolt in bearing, because our bolt connection will fail only in two criteria. The first criteria is with respect to shear, and the second criteria is with respect to bearing. The bolt should be designed for the failures against shear and for the first criteria, we will check the design in shearing, and then we will check the design in bearing, as these both are the failure in bolts. So first, when I go to design my bolt connection with respect to shear failure, how the failure will occur? Due to application of tensile force of my bolt in my connection, if the, let us assume this is my bolt, the bolt will fail in this manner. If I going to place my bolt over here, my bolt will fail in this manner, because of the zone here will be our shear zone. This zone what will be our shear zone. In this zone, due to application of forces in different direction, due to application of forces in different direction, generate some shear which will chop off the bolts into two parts. To calculate the shear failure, which is generally VDSB, which is the formula is also given in the code, clause 10.3 by root 3 gamma MB NN A and B plus ANS ASB. In this formula, there are two terms which are NN and NS. When the shear intercept the threaded portion, in that cases we have to use NN. And when the shear intersecting the non-threaded portion in the shank, non-threaded portion, there we have to consider NS. In this case, the shear is intersecting only the threaded portion. We are assuming that the threads in bolts are in this manner. In our case, we are assuming the threads in the bolt starting in this manner. So NN value will be 1, as there is only one shear zone. And we can see there is only one shear zone, and NS is 0. ANB value, which is 0.78 times of pi by 4 d square, as it is given in the question to use M20 bolts. It means that the diameter of bolt will be 20 mm, whereas the diameter of bolt hole will be about 22 mm. So when I calculate the shear capacity of bolt, this will be equal to 400 by root 3 into 1.25. 1.25 is from the table number 5, code IS 800-2007, and the term in grade 4.6 represents the ultimate strength, which means the ultimate strength of bolt will be 400 Newton per mm square. NN is 1, ANB which if I substitute the value of d as 20 mm, this will be around 245 mm square, plus ns is 0, no need to calculate asb. If I substitute the formula, the shear capacity of bolt will be around 45.3 into 10 cube newtons, which is 45.3 kilo newtons. This is the first type of failure in bolts. The next type of failure in bolts with respect to bearing. In the case of bearing, the failure will be certainly seen in this manner. When we are calculating the failure with respect to bearing, the formula in the code is given as VD PB equal to 2.5 times of KB DT FU by gamma M. Here, this is the yield strength of plate. Previous case, it was the yield strength of bolt. If I show you the previous case, when we are going to calculate the shear failure, in shear failure, we have took the yield strength, the ultimate strength of bolt. In this case, we are taking the ultimate strength of plate. In this case, the bolt is failing. See, the bolt have been chopped off into two pieces. That is why even the code recommended to take FUB. And in this case, the plate is going to fail due to the application of bearing forces. When we want to study about bearing forces, in the